Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let's see all about graph representation. Basically, a graph can be represented in two methods, guys. One of them is adjacency matrix and another one is adjacency list. Whereas in adjacency matrix, we will be using a matrix representation, and in adjacency list, we will be using arrays and linked list. That's the main idea of these two representations, guys. So now let us go through them in depth now. So adjacency matrix, a graph can be represented in the form of a matrix using A of ij, where I comma j are the vertices. So if there is an edge between these two vertices, we will be giving the number 1. If not, we'll be giving 0. So now I hope everyone got a small idea. So once you are going through the example, it will be crystal clear for you guys. Don't worry, I'm here to help you. Okay, so now here there is an undirected graph given, right? I hope everyone is clearly observing it. Okay, so this is an undirected graph as there are no particular directions. So basically, draw a matrix, guys. Here, all how many variables are there? Those are nothing but how many vertices. Sorry, how many vertices are there? 4 vertices. So that will be a 4x4 matrix. So write 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Those vertices, names or numbers or something. So that if there is an edge between 1, 2, you will be placing 1. If there is no edge between 1, 1, you'll be placing 0. That's it. Using that logic, you are going to fill the whole matrix. So now I hope everyone is clear with it. So you may also ask me that there is any possibility of having like this. These are nothing but self loops, guys. We call them as self loops. They reflect themselves. So if they are there, we're gonna get here one and here one, like that. It's going to change according to the diagram. So now I hope you got an idea. Okay, let us go through directed graph. In directed graph, we are having particular directions, right? See, here we are having like this, like this, like this, like this, like this, like this. Okay, so we are having particular directions. So now according to the direction, if E2S, only E2S will be having 1, whereas there is no E2E, so it is 0. Like that, we will be filling this matrix. So now let us go through this adjacency list. I have told you that we will be using arrays and linked list. That's what the definition, guys. We can represent any graph by using arrays and linked list. Okay, let us take the example of an undirected graph. Let us assume this as an undirected graph, so that we will be defining an array which consists of the vertices, such that from the vertices we will be linking the links. For 1 we are having 2, for 1 we are having 3, for 1 we are having 4. So I created three link parts, so that 1 represents 2, 3, 4, nothing but 3 nodes. 1 represents 2, 3, 4, like that. I have just made this. Similarly, for directed graph, we will be having some particular directions. Remember, there is also a possibility that the link may be empty if there are no edges in that direction referring from V3 to. So here all the edges are coming towards E3, but there is no outgoing edge. So in that situation, we will be not having any link part. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on this whole topic. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through graph traversals, guys. That's really an important topic. In that, we'll be covering BFS and DFS, guys. Please don't miss the next tutorial. Thank you. Thanks for watching.